So this last weekend, I went out on a shoot with Austin Lindsay, and we were taking some photos for a future few videos we've got planned for you that are really exciting. Without giving too much away about those videos, I noticed something while scanning those photos that I don't think I would have noticed if I hadn't started shooting large format. And so today in this video, I want to show you how you can check the focus in these older folding cameras before you put a roll through it. And all you're gonna need for this is some wax paper, some tape, and a measuring tape. So let's hop outside and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so I actually wanna show you this picture really quick before we jump outside so that you can understand what's going on here. So when a camera takes a picture, light travels through the lens and imprints on a negative or on a sensor. When everything lines up perfectly, a photo is made and it's in focus. Now with most cameras, that's as easy as it needs to be. But when you step into large format, or when you're using a folding camera or a tilt shift lens, you learn a little bit more about planes of focus. Now looking at this specific picture, I know right before, me and Austin both checked the focus distance and it seemed right. Now what's interesting about this photo is the depth of field doesn't seem to be quite parallel with the lens and the film. As you start learning more about large format and tilt shift, you learn a little bit about camera movements and how they can impact your focal plane. Now this main problem can be checked beforehand by looking at the camera body and the lens and making sure they are parallel to each other. And if it seems like the lens is tilted one direction left or right, make sure you move it back to parallel before you take any photos. Now another problem that you can run into with these cameras is that they're old and the focusing systems just might not be accurate. So rather than wasting a whole roll before you find this out, head to an area with a lot of light. What you're gonna wanna do is choose an object that is fairly contrasty and would be easy to focus on. Then look at your lens and determine what the minimum focal distance is. For this lens, it's 3.5 feet. So I'm taking the tape measure and measuring exactly 3.5 feet away from this tree. Now this measurement is going to be from the object that's in focus to where the film would be resting. Then all you have to do is cut a piece of wax paper so that it covers the same amount of area that the film would be covering and tape it in place so that it stays tight. Go ahead and throw a blanket over your head to eliminate the extra light on the back of the camera so that you can see exactly what the camera is seeing. Then once your camera is set to bulb mode, all you have to do is open the aperture as wide as it goes. In this case, it's 3.5, and hold down the shutter. Putting it in bulb mode and holding down the shutter is going to keep the lens open and allow the image to go through the lens onto the wax paper and stay there rather than just opening and closing. Now, if the image is sharp and in focus, you're good to go. There's no issues. You can use the camera. You can also change the focus to infinity just to check that there's no additional issues. But if the image isn't in focus, go ahead and change the focus until it is. Then all you have to do is take a note as to what the focal distance on the lens says. And then you can use that information in the future to adjust your focus to make sure that it is tack sharp every single time. Now, unfortunately, I don't know any specific fixes besides noting it down and making adjustments. So if you're watching this and you do know specifically how to fix these issues, please leave a comment down below and let us know. This video is just to help you determine if there's an issue or not without spending a lot of money on extra rolls of film. I hope this video was useful for someone out there and I saved you a little bit of time and money. Please stay tuned because, like I said, we do have a few videos coming up in the future from this collaboration with Austin. Make sure to subscribe to his channel if you haven't. And until next time, I'll see you later.